you do life.
I see my name in shiny lights. Yeah, a different city every night. Oh, I swear the world better prepare for when I'm a billionaire.
It's time to get down to business on the weekend's number one business program. Known as the King of Networking, your host, Shalom Klein, has worked with thousands of entrepreneurs and created countless jobs. So, to success, let's get down to business.
And indeed, we are all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship and business. We talk a lot about business here. You're on with Get Down to Business, and I'm your host, Shalom Klein. Remember, you can always download podcasts from Get Down to Business on my website at shalomklein.com. While you're there, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Shalom Klein. It's a jam-packed week. Some fantastic guests, lots of information for you. You don't want to miss a minute of it. We've got some tips for you, employment tips, at the end of the program. So every time I hear that intro song, I smile because I love it. I'm an entrepreneur and I love to encourage entrepreneurship. But it certainly is a great intro for my very first guest on the program this evening. Cortlon Cofield is the owner and advisor of Cofield Advisors. He is very, very dedicated to helping specifically millennials take a holistic approach to financial planning and advising, helping them become millionaires or, frankly, any goals. Cortlon, it's a pleasure to have you on the program. Welcome to Get Down to Business.
Thank you, Shalom. Happy to be here, man.
Absolutely. So we had fun the other day watching the horses race, and and it's great when millennials can get to that point that they have some money to play around with, but you don't want to play around too much. Cortlon, you must have a personal story of why you do what you do and how you do it so well. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
So I have undergraduate and a master's degree in accounting. I'm also a CPA and a PFS, which is a personal financial specialist. So that's kind of my background. How I got started with Cofield Advisors is, I'll try to make a long story short. A lot of my colleagues, I worked in accounting and finance for a while, and a lot of my colleagues were young. We made a good money, but they always had like financial stress and financial uncertainties. You know, whether that was enormous credit card debt or not knowing how to restructure their student loans or anything of that nature. And they would always come to me because they knew I had the specialty. And they really felt like they had nowhere else to go. And as you may know, a lot of these big companies, I won't name any names, but they have these huge AUM minimums, which basically means if you don't have five figures, liquid cash to invest with them, they're not talking to you. So I wanted to start a firm where I could work with millennials and give them the advice and help that they need without these restrictions. So that's how I got started.
That's fantastic. So a lot of financial advisors only want to work with people that, frankly, have a lot of money in the bank and a lot of money to, for lack of a better term, play around with. Is that how Cofield Advisors works? Who's your ideal client?
Absolutely not. So my ideal household, my household range from $70,000 in annual to maybe about $400,000, $500,000. And that's income. That's not investable assets. The biggest problem with millennials is that they don't have the time that a 55-year-old has to accumulate all these assets, but they do have expendable income. Now, helping them prioritize where the income should go is huge. It could be tremendous to building that nest egg for the future.
Oh, absolutely. So I know on your website, which, of course, we're going to share with our listeners to make sure that they can get to know you, learn a little bit about your background and so on. So you pride yourself, I know, on how you work. And as you just mentioned, working with everybody. But you have a few different sort of packages, but you pride yourself on being a fee-based financial advisor. What's the difference? Why is that unique, and why should that matter to your clients and the community at large?
Well, so there's fee-only, there's fee-based, and then there's commissions. So basically, it all comes down to conflict of interest. People that are not fee-only or fee-based, they get paid by outside brokers. So if Fidelity is going to pay you to put as many people in their fund. So you have a conflict of interest with doing what's in the client's best interest or what's in your best interest to get paid the most. What I wanted to do is eliminate all conflicts of interest so that my client knows 100% that I am working for them and I'm only paid by them. So that takes all the conflict of interest out the door and allows us to build a great, trustworthy relationship.
Oh, that's fantastic. And so you have worked really, really hard, and you clearly have fun in helping your clients quite a bit. You write a fantastic blog on your website. The most recent blog is How to Become a Millionaire on Accident. And I love that title because, hey, who doesn't think about it? So tell me a little bit about sort of your strategy and your approach. Or do you consider yourself to be a risk taker, or, and this might be more of a personal anecdote and personal sort of reflection. Do you consider yourself to be a risk taker, or are you more conservative in your approach and how you work in general?
Well, I don't know if I say risk versus conservative, but I would say I definitely believe in a passive investing approach, and that's basically people investing in low cost index funds, ETFs, because what that does is it just tracks the market, right? You're not trying to beat the market, you're trying to get the market. And it's very easy to do. And the most misunderstood thing about investing is fees. Mutual funds and some of these actively managed funds have huge fees. And I don't know if you know this, but a 1% fee on a fund over 30 years takes 26% of your portfolio.
Wow. Wow.
So if you have $1 million, that's like $250,000. And it's just fees alone. So that's my investing approach, is passive, low cost, because I want my clients to get the most that they can from their investments.
So let's talk millennials, Cortlon. I get depressed sometimes when I see statistics about millennials, and I think that often people have this conversation. Millennials have a conversation about, well, it's too early. I don't have enough money right now. It's not the right time to sort of start the conversation about saving and putting aside money. I've got certain goals. I've got certain things I want to do with my life. And I'll have that conversation when I, and then they fill in the blank of a certain age or a certain milestone in some way. Cortlon, what advice do you have for a millennial, for an entrepreneur that might be listening to the program thinking, again, that the time is right now? What advice can you share?
It's never too early to start. And I'm actually heavily happy you brought that up, because the hardest part of my job is undoing the past 100 years that the industry has done and built itself on. Like, financial planning and advising is only for old people. But like, if you catch somebody young and give them the proper tools to, you know, update their financial literacy and save and invest and do these right things, you can make such a bigger impact on their lives than you could somebody that's 57, right? Compound interest, best friend is time. So it's never too early. I would recommend starting as early as possible. And once I explain that, they kind of get on board, because you know, it's not about the money you have. It's about the mindset, because it's not how much money you make. It's how much money you keep.
That's true. And it's always fascinating. I mean, I enjoy reading, and I see all these articles, and sometimes the approach is shaming people into, you know, feeling bad, like, oh, I didn't do this. I've been spending $3 on a cup of coffee, and that money could have turned into something. And that's a very valid point, that money could have been well spent. It sounds like, Cortlon, you take a very positive and a very, call it, inspirational approach in helping people wherever you're at, whatever age, wherever you're at financially, whether you have $100 or $100,000, we can do something with that money.
Yes, and you know, like, it's a big misconception is that, like, you know, we're not here to shame people, right? So much of my job is psychological, right? It's not
sure.
Like, you spend $300 on shoes. It's like, why? And what are you willing to sacrifice? Like, is vacation important? Well, we'll keep vacationing, but, you know, we'll sacrifice some other place. So it's so psychological, and it really is just changing someone's mindset and their behavior. But it's definitely not shaming, because you are not identified by your past financial decisions.
Sure. Well, you're clearly a great messenger for this, and you can relate because this is who you are, and I know you've got a very interesting story. We are quickly running out of time, and I want to make sure that people can learn more about you, Cortlon Cofield, again, and get in touch real soon. So how can people find out more, and how can people contact you?
Well, they can go to cofieldadvisors.com, cofieldadvisors.com, and to schedule a consultation. My phone number and contact email is on my website. And I work with clients all around the world virtually. So it's not just like Chicago.
Sure.
I have clients in 7 different states. So, yeah, just reach out, and then, you know, we'll talk.
That's fantastic. Cofieldadvisors.com. Really appreciate your time on the program, and certainly we'll stay in touch to continue to get your advice in the future.
All right, man. Have a great day. Thanks for having
me. Well, very appropriate that we had Cortlon Cofield on the program because my next guest, Jeff Williams, he is with Biz Starters, and he is actually focusing quite a bit on another age range, and we're going to talk a little bit about that after the break. So, Chicago, don't touch that dial. You're listening to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship. As always, I encourage you to get in touch with our sponsors, Tandem HR, your solution center, tandemhr.com. Give them a call, 630-928-0510, 630-928-0510. Give them a call. They'll give you a free consultation to talk about HR. And as I mentioned at the end of the program, I'm going to be sharing some employment tips, HR tips. You don't want to miss it. Chicago, don't touch that dial. You're listening to Get Down to Business.
How can you get from here to there? We've got the answer from the Balance of Nature Traffic Center.
I'm Eddie Manzano in the Balance of Nature Traffic Center.